I'm rolling. It won't take long where I'm going, but I don't know if I get there, I'll get there. I'll sure find my way back.
The Old Mutual Joburg to see. Delivered by Avis Van Rendel.
The beautiful Kenmo Lake here at Hazeldene as we prepare for stage 7 of the Old Mutual Joburg2c. It's a day to savor for those who enjoy single track, because it's going to be fun all the way down to Mackenzie Club for around 75 kilometers.
Day 6 was something of a monster, but it was conquered by the field in all manner of ways as the race's biggest climb to snow top was melted. The 14k descent thrashed, the Death Valley climb stared down, and the unrideable enduro section flattened. The snow-capped peaks of the Berg provided magnificent backdrops as the heroes and heroines of the race took another giant step towards the Indian Ocean. Again, the country's colourful contrasts were evident as we relaxed under the autumnal leaves alongside Kenmo Lake at the tranquil Hazeldene campsite. Stage 7 is a ride through the timber and dairy belt of KwaZulu-Natal as we leave the Drakensberg behind us. The hallmark of this stage is its single track, much of it dual. The Oak Lane section comes after 20k's, and shortly afterwards it's the Pines with more dual track leading us onto the Mossbank Dam and its famed and fabled floating bridge. There's no mistaking the terrain as we climb through forest plantations for long periods to make up the 1400 meters of climbing. A swing through the lush pastures of Alsace Farm brings us home to the wonderful people at Mackenzie Club. We rolled away from Hazeldene in bitterly cold conditions, perhaps the coldest start of the entire race, saying goodbye to a race village that had provided wonderful, wonderful hospitality. The open roads on the way out of Underberg gave the riders chance to warm up those cold legs and stretch out on some long downhills. Attacking early, Louis Breston-Leip, and on the frontier, Kevin van Heuvels, the former Belgian national champion, back to full fitness. Timo Cooper leading them into the Oak Lane single track. Dual single track here, choose left or right and give it horns. Absolutely beautiful riding in pristine conditions. The heat over the last few weeks had created these hard-packed trails. Leading them into the enduro section were Team Contigo. Split up were Fed Group by Tech Connect and Resium. Prince Maseku going well, as was Nico Fitzenmaier and Timo Cooper. Jared van Sydam and his partner, Stuve Rawlinson, in the subvets. Kevin Evans leading the solo. And the single speeders having a blast. Nick White. The rowers, Rob Dormal, and on the front, Matthew Britton, a gold medalist from London 2012. Yolandi de Toy and Nikki Krobler of Bizhub USN. The forest, a wonderful playground for us. The Moss Bank and its beautiful floating bridge, always a challenge and something the riders look ahead to nervously but deal with competently. Plenty of climbing and lots of fast downhills, thoroughly enjoyed by all the riders as we headed towards Mackenzie Club. Jenny Steenhoek and Craig Gerber in the mixed. Through Ngumeni Forest and Donnybrook, we're headed towards Mackenzie, and the lead group now settling down. Fed Group, iTech Connect, Contigo, as well as ReCM. Unfortunately, Cannondale Blend were down to one rider, Darren Lill riding alone because his partner Charles Key had pulled up ill. And at the finish, the sprint was won by Louis Breston-Leip and Kevin van Heuvels ahead of Fed Group, iTech Connect, with ReCM's Wilcock and Luce in third place. But nothing changing in the overall standings. Eric and Ariane Kleinans dominant again, their sixth win in the mixed race. And Ishan and Yolandi winning the women's. Back on form are the two Joburg2c ladies. A fantastic comeback by the Contigo pair, but they're not in contention overall due to their day 5 troubles. Fed Group iTech Connect made sure their closest rivals ReCM were marked all the way to the finish. Joburg2c ladies Ishan and Yolandi showed their skill and experience on the single tracks. They increased their overall lead to 15 minutes over Cherie Stunder and Lisa Ulafir of Barry Stunder Foundation. While mixed race leaders ReCM collected their 6th stage win, Nusli and Komiberf had their best day since stage 2, and Team Gisler were 3rd over 8 minutes down on the Kleinhans pair, who have a 22-minute lead over Bizhub Rocky Mountain. Fed Group iTech Connect's Kevin Evans is still the man in charge in the solo race. He improved his advantage over Billy Stelling to 1 hour and 5 minutes. Our first look at the Masters reveals a great first 7 days for the USN Masters pair of Chris Brand and Mark Langman, who won once again into Mackenzie Club ahead of the Makadas men Louis Knipe and Theo Scribante, with the Aramex SA pair of Robbie McIntosh and Tim James third. On GC, the USN Masters have just under 3 hours in hand, whilst former Report Tour winner McIntosh and Freedom Challenge legend Tim James are 27 minutes ahead of the Makadas pair. The Red Bull Enduro section gave us a taste of Farmer Glenn's unique creative trail-building skills as we swept through the dual single track and popped out onto Mossbank Dam, an adrenaline rush of note. Nico Fitzenmaier of Team Bridge putting his full sus Momsen Viper to good use to win today's Red Bull Enduro stage in 4 minutes and 17 seconds, 6 seconds faster than Enduro and downhill guru Gary Barnard, who is testing out a Carbon Trek Superfly.
Old Mutual Joberg2c goes through a lot of different farms. Over 100 landowners that we deal with at the moment, and I'm sure we'll be picking that up as we find more and more routes along the way. Initially it was we had to convince the farmers that it was a good thing to do, but because it's a community-based thing, often they're involved in the event some way, you know, either their children or their managers' children or at the schools that we support. So it's as soon as they've realized that this event is helping them and their communities, they buy into the whole Old Mutual Joburg2c quite quickly.
My name is John Demport. We have a limousine stud herd of cattle on the Vaal Dam with 16 kilometers of waterfront. You've got three amazing organizers for this race. You've got Craig Wapnick. He approached me as an ex-squash player, and it was just by coincidence that he realized that we had a farm and it was the perfect place to cross the Vaal Dam. So Craig and I met, and he has been asking me for the last 4 years, and I'm not getting any younger, so I thought now is the time. I've got a bit of time and I could do the race. I'm doing pretty well, thanks. Doing great.
I'm James Leslie. I farm in the Harry Smith area in the Eastern Free State. We grow maize, potatoes, wheat and beans. We farm on a scale of about 4,500 hectares. And we produce about 35,000 tons of produce a year. I've ridden in the race for 4 years, and after the first year the guys took us on a hell of a lot of district road, and that's when I got involved, just to get the riders off dirt road and myself off dirt road too. So we started building some trails, all the Jabulani trails.
I started farming in 2011, April, the 1st of April. on April's Fool. I bought the farm on an auction. I started chicken farming with VKB, which is a crane field chicken. I'm getting a very good neighbors that are white farmers, that are mentor to me. It's not difficult if you go to the people and you talk and they are willing to help. I'm going
down to a stage of fast racing, sweet flowing single track and a few big climbs and more wonderful hospitality. Another fantastic day on the Old Mutual Joberg2c. And it gets better with the Umkomaas Valley, just one of the highlights awaiting us on stage 8. Enjoy the fun we had on the trails today with Gerald Clark and don't miss tomorrow's show.
Well, I wonder why some people treat you strangers so. Well, I wonder why some people treat you strangers so. Maybe your best friend that you never know. I'm going down to the railway station. I'm gonna get myself a train and ride. I'm gonna leave your silly father behind.
The Old Mutual Joburg2c, delivered by Avis Van Rendel.